In this view, we will be demonstrating an axial-lateral inferior-superior trauma hip, the Clemens-Nakayama view. The axial-lateral inferior-superior trauma hip, Clemens-Nakayama view, should be performed with a patient lying supine on the table. A 40-inch source-to-image distance and tube angle must be directed 15 degrees posteriorly and align perpendicular to the femoral neck. This is an axial lateral view. When the patient doesn't have much movement or we have a bilateral injury, there's not a good leg to move. So we are having a left image here. We are going to use a 15 degree posterior angle with the central ray perpendicular to the femoral neck. We have a left marker indicating the left side of the body. I have utilized a 40-inch SID. The patient is not moving, so they're going to hold still for us, and the exposure is taken. A diagnostic axial lateral inferior superior trauma hip, Clemens-Nakayama view, radiograph must be free of motion. Demonstrated anatomy to include the hip joint with the acetabulum, femoral head, neck, and trochanters, with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the axial-lateral inferior-superior trauma hip Danielle-Smiller view. The axial-lateral inferior-superior trauma hip Danielle-Smiller view should be performed with the patient lying supine on the table. A 40-inch source-to-image distance, and no tube angulation. Patient is on their back, and the left leg is injured, so we never want to move an injured leg. So we're moving the uninjured leg, we've propped it up, and the more that we can flex the leg or the flexibility of the patient, we want to get the leg up as much as we can. The central ray is in between the legs. It is the perpendicular to the long axis of the femoral neck. So we have used 40 inches SID. I have indicated the left leg with a left marker. The patient is holding very still. She holds her breath and the exposure is made. A diagnostic axial lateral inferior superior trauma hip Danielle-Smiller view radiograph must be free of motion. Demonstrated anatomy to include the hip joint with the acetabulum. Femoral neck free of superimposition of the greater trochanter with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.